Hello everybody, this is Bill Soto with Xorcom, and I'd like to give you a quick presentation on implementing IP telephony into your local area network. First, let's discuss the three core elements of any IP telephony implementation, and that would be the IP PBX itself, a data switch, and a router. Now the data switch, you can see a couple of acronyms there, QoS and PoE. QoS is a feature of a data switch to ensure that voice that is being passed over the broadband network or your local area network and get high priority to ensure good voice quality. PoE stands for Power Over Ethernet. That is providing power to IP telephones through the Cat5 or Cat6 cabling. The router also can provide QoS if you're using a voice over IP service or something called SIP trunking, which stands for Session Initiation Protocol. Basically, it's a protocol that's used to talk over broadband. These three core elements should be placed on a battery backup unit to ensure that voice communications are not interrupted during a power outage. So the router does its job and connects to the internet to supply internet access for your computers connected on the network. The telephone system, or the PBX server, is connected to your local telephone company for either analog phone lines or digital circuits such as PRI, T1 or E1, or with R2 signaling, just depending on which part of the world you're installed in. Now there's another acronym in that cloud that I have for the Public Switch Telephone Network, or the PSTN. You'll see an ITSP. That's an Internet Telephony Service Provider. This is an ISP, Internet Service Provider. A good example would be a cable provider, a cable company, that provides broadband. They now purchase equipment and they install in their back office so they can provide telephone service over that same broadband circuit that goes to your home or office. So if you're going to use this service, you can then provide the telephone service through the wide area network or the broadband network, and it does not come through the regular analog phone lines or T1. You can have these services running simultaneously. So at this point in time, we have a telephone system connected on your network, and we're connected to the outside world. So now let's go ahead and bring that connectivity into the office. So we run our cables, and then we connect our cables to an IP telephone. Now most IP telephones, not all of them, but most of them, have two data ports in the back. One is connected for the phone on the network, and then the other one is another data port so you can connect a computer or laptop. So you can have two logical devices on one cable. You can also just connect computers directly to the network as well. Now, most companies have something in their office that is analog. It may be a cordless telephone, analog phone, maybe a credit card machine, a fax machine. With Xorcom, we can connect your existing cabling, your Cat3 cable or the skinny wire, directly to ports on our telephone system. We have the ports built in, or it could also be connected through an AstroBank. But needless to say, Xorcom has done a very nice job of migrating analog technology into the world of IP. We can also connect to the system a soft phone on a laptop or a remote IP phone. This can all be connected on the same network as well. Now, what we normally recommend for remote phones is that you connect through a secure connection like a VPN and never really connect through the open internet or something of that nature, which obviously leaves your network open on the internet for hackers. And lastly, we can connect also remote office sites. So if you have another office site where it dictates that they have their own telephone system there, they have maybe several telephones, or they have a lot of phone lines in that area, and they just want to connect, so this way you can do desk-to-desk dialing between the two systems. As an example, Xorcom has offices in Israel, in Phoenix, Arizona, and in Puerto Rico, as well as Cookeville, Tennessee. All the offices are interconnected, and we can dial each other through that network. So basically, this ends the quick little overview of implementing IP telephony into your network. It's just a high-level overview so you can see how it all comes together. Thank you very much, and hope you enjoyed it.